And moving on, in other news, British Foreign Secretary Boris Johnson has been reprimanded by House of Commons Speaker for using sexist language in the Parliament. Speaker John Bercow intervened after Johnson referred to Shadow Foreign Secretary Emily Thornberry as Lady Newgie. Thornberry is married to High Court Judge Sir Christopher Newgie, but she chooses to go by her maiden name. Let's listen into that interaction.
It is the most. Say no, says the Labour front bench. That's their attitude. That's their attitude. Isn't that extraordinary? Isn't that extraordinary? This is an institution. Say no, says the noble and learned lady, the Baroness, whatever it is. I can't remember what it is. Newgie. What an extraordinary thing. This is an institution that encompasses 2.4 billion people, some of the fastest growing economies in the world, and we have an unrivalled opportunity to embrace them here in London, and we're going to do it.
Two things. First of all, we don't name call in this chamber. And secondly, I'm dealing with the matter. The right honourable gentleman will listen and benefit from listening. Secondly, we do not address people by the titles of their spouses. The Shadow Foreign Secretary has a name. And it's not Lady something. We know what her name is. And it is inappropriate and frankly sexist to speak in those terms. And I'm not having it in this chamber. That is the end of the matter. No matter how senior a member, that parlance is not legitimate. It will not be allowed, and it will be called out on it, and I require no chuntering from a secretary position from any occupant of the Treasury bench. I've said what the position is, and believe me, that is the end of the matter. I hope I've made the position extremely clear to people who are not well informed about such matters.
Mr. Speaker, can I crave your indulgence just to prostrate myself before you and to apologise for any inadvertent sexism or discourtesy that you may have deemed me to be to have been guilty of, and I heartily tender my apologies to the right honourable lady opposite if she was offended by what I said, and I meant no harm. I meant no harm, Mr. Speaker, and I apologise unreservedly if I've offended the feelings of the right honourable lady.